It was a tough week for the Wildcats as one of their top players went down for the season. We'll tell you who it was. And the UK women were at home trying to lock down an SEC tournament bye. Get your upset caps ready because Sportszone 50 starts right now. Welcome in, everyone. It's Sportszone 50, your only student sports authority. I'm Ryan Mollenkopf, alongside with Justin Stewart. Justin, last Wednesday, it was the men's basketball team playing host to Ole Miss in a tough SEC battle for the Cats.
Ole Miss Kentucky highlights here. First half, Joe Crawford knocked him down, the big three. Crawford put him up early, 11-2. Then it's Real Bradley knocking down the big three-pointer there. Bradley with a quiet 14 points on the night. And then slowly it turned into Perry Stevenson's show, getting the ball down low from Patrick Patterson and putting it up and in. And then at the other end, it's Perry Stevenson showing that defense, blocking his man. And then what? He hustled him on the floor, diving for the rebound. And then you got Perry Stevenson finishing off the flush here. Stevenson with 7 points all in the first half. Then right before halftime, Merrill Bradley. Nice little fadeaway jumper there. Cats up at half, 31-14. Second half now, Chris Warren went off for Ole Miss. Hitting three after three after three. Bringing Ole Miss back, and Warren with 23 points on the night. Not too bad there. And it all came down to this play as Warren drives down two. Ole Miss hit the layup? No. But the ball gets kicked out to Trevor Gaskins, who shoots. Oh, but he misses the three. Kentucky would get the rebound. Bradley would go to the free throw line, shoot two free throws. He would hit both, and Kentucky goes on to victory, 58-54.
And for the post game, we go to Annie Lubecki.
UK basketball was almost as sloppy as the weather tonight in Lexington as the Cats took on Ole Miss in SEC play. After completely dominating the first half, the Cats felt a fierce chill as the Rebels took over rebounding in the second half.
That's a real good win for us. We were lucky to escape and excited about escaping. And we played great at the start, not very good at the end, but very lucky to get one win out of it tonight.
You know, I think we did. We lost a little focus. We didn't, you know, do the same things we did on defense, and they applied more pressures on defense. You know, we couldn't get the ball reversed and have a fluid offense.
And as Coach Billy Gillespie said, his favorite play of the game was the three-point miss for the Rebels, as it would have been the go-ahead win for the Rebels at the end of the game.
God let him miss, you know, and he missed it, but. Only by a hair.
Is that the power of prayer?
I hope so, because I'm going to have to start doing that a little more often.
It went down to the wire today. We let those guys back in the game. They did a really good job of fighting back, getting on the glass, and putting themselves in position to win.
When the shot was in the air, did you think Ole Miss made it to win it?
When the shot was in the air, I was just like, God, don't do this to me. Please don't do this to us right now. And it hit the back of the rim. It looked good. It looked good. It did look good.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I thought it was going in. I went out to try to contest a shot, but the guy had such a quick release on it. You know, I don't even think I got my hands above my head. You know, I just turned around and looked, and I thought it was about to be a swish, not my neck, because, like, it was dead on, perfect. You know, and when he missed it, you know, it was just a big sigh of relief.
Does that explain your guys' season so far or this last few games?
I think it does. I mean, luck is on our side. I mean, that's how we all feel, that luck is on our side, and we're able to pull out the win in crunch time situations.
Reporting from Rupp Arena, I'm Annie Lubecki for Sportszone 50.
And that catches up to this week as it was a dark day on campus as it was announced that unfortunately big man Patrick Patterson was out for the season.
A tough day for us in the regard of losing Pat Patterson, and unfortunate mostly for him as a person, and he means so much to our team and as a player and a person and just everything. I have not been around a freshman that's been asked to do more and that has done more for a team. And from day one, he's been expected to be a great player, and he's done that and more as a freshman. Very, very tough day for him personally, I know. very tough day for us as a team. And we've already had a practice, and our guys understand how tough it's going to be. It's going to be a lot tougher, but it's not impossible. And it's been I think our team has played a special way of basketball in conference season, and we'll just have to be a little bit more special without him. We're going to miss him. It's not the end of the world. He'll be back before too long. Unfortunately, not for this season, but just a tough day, but we'll make the most out of it.
Any questions? Patrick, could you kind of first explain when this started, hurt, when you found out what it was, and then just what your reaction was today when they told you?
Woke up Tuesday morning, and to some pain in my left ankle. It was on the inside, just right on the tip of my bone. Reported it right to the trainer, Eric. You know, I got treatment right away, told my coach in practice. And, you know, we just treated it like just a regular ankle injury, you know, treatment in the underwater treadmill, a bunch of ice, bunch of game-ready coolers, just everything, you know, that you do to an ankle that hurts. You know, then it started feeling better progressively, played in the game, started hurting towards the end. You know, I got more treatment, and we talked about getting the x-ray. You know, and woke up this morning, and me and him decided to go get an x-ray, and found out that I had a little stress fracture, you know, right in my middle malleola, something like that. I can't remember how to pronounce it. But, you know, I was shocked when I found out about it, and they told me I had to wear a cast for about 6 to 8 weeks. You know, I started crying when I found out that I couldn't play for the rest of the remaining season. You know, I was just disappointed. And, you know, I just had to tell my teammates and I had to tell my coach.
Patrick endured stress fracture in his right foot, but even without Patterson, Kentucky still had to take on the number one ranked Tennessee Volunteers on Sunday. They came from 15 down. Perry Stevenson, who had 13 points and 14 boards, slamming it into the cut to lead to 4. Ramon Harrison came up with a 3-point play. Who would have saw that as the Cats pushed in front 42-41, looking a little bit like Ramel Bradley with that shot. But there the lead went back and forth. Joe Crawford off the baseline to put Kentucky up by 1. About 1 minute to go, Chris Laughlin, who already had 14, throwing it high off the glass with the kiss to the Vols, and they were up 6. Kentucky still had a couple of chances to tie it right at the end. The time ran out, and Tennessee held on 63-60. Mel Bradley did lead the Cats with 17. Can we say possible SEC Player of the Year? And Tyler Smith led Tennessee with 15 points.
The UK Bearcats were playing host to Butler this past week, and Kentucky dominated Butler, sweeping the series, winning 63-7 over the week. The Bearcats moved their record to 9-0 on the season as they open a 4-game homestand next week against Purdue.
And the UK women's team was taking on South Carolina on senior night. The Gamecocks came out early and jumped out to a quick lead, but the Lady Cats fought back in the second half behind Samantha Mahoney's 12 points. The Cats pulled the game all the way back to within 2 points thanks to Carly Omerod. But Kentucky falls 65-57 to the Gamecocks. But thanks to a Georgia loss, UK women's team gets a first-round bye in their first round of the SEC tournament. Congratulations to the Lady Cats.
And you can catch us Sundays from 2 to 4 on WRFL 88.1, where we talk about everything going on in the sports world.
All right, guys, you've seen us on ESPN. You're seeing us here at Channel 50. You might be looking at us on YouTube, but you can also go to our website, www.sportzone50.com. That's www.sportzone50.com, where you can view our blog or check out our podcast.
Well, we won't have a show next week because of spring break, but we'll bring you all the SEC tournament coverage the week after spring break. Remember, go to class, use a designated driver, and always bleed blue.
And remember, everybody, it's the same bad time, same bad channel, same bad place, same bad website. Have a great week, everybody. I don't know the lyrics to this song. All right, cut.